Hello, my crafty peeps. It's Cheyenne from pixiecrafter.com. I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator and artist. If you are looking for a demonstrator, I would love to be yours. If you have any questions on any Stampin' Up! Products, feel free to contact me. If there are any videos or Stampin' Up! Products that you'd like to see, you can contact me too. Just leave a comment and I will do what I can to accommodate. Alright, so today's video is kind of a continuation of last Tuesday's video showing you all of the Eastern medallion dyes. So remember we did this little fun thing. Gorgeousness, total gorgeousness. So I have this a piece and this a piece that I cut out while I was doing that video. So if you want to see how these are done, refer to that video. So with these, there is so much that can be done with these, but I saw something, you know, simple for this video. So I've put together something that's, you know, easy for everyone to do. I didn't want to go too technique heavy, but you could absolutely sponge over these. Any colors, use a sponge spray or sponge dauber sponges, you know, use any color ink that you want, have a nice little effect. I would say if you're going to do that though, do it before you die cut it all. I just think it would be a lot easier to get all through all of that. So you can use any color paper you want, whatever. I'm going to keep these white. I like the simplicity of them. I like how they look kind of like lace doilies. So that's what we're sticking with. Oh, I have cut these pieces down to 4 by 5 1/4, both of them, so that they'll layer quite nicely. And for card bases, I have from the Eastern Palace bundle, you get these two shades and Dapper Denim. So this is Tranquil Turquoise and Fresh Fig. And I've just got two standard A2 size card bases. So they're cut 5.5 by 8.5, scored at 4 1/4. Right? Right, yes. All right, I had to think about that for a second. Numbers weren't seeming right, but yes, that is it. All right. And here I used the largest circle from the Layering Circles dies, and I've got a piece of Blushing Bride. This is retiring, so if you love Blushing Bride, get your hands on it before it's too late, and a piece of Very Vanilla, and we are going to alter this and have some fun. I'm going to show you another fun thing that you can do with all of your embossing stuff. So speaking of embossing stuff, you're going to need your heat tool. I recently purchased the Stampin' Up! Heat Tool, and I am loving it. It really is the best heat tool that I've ever used, and it's fantastic. It just further goes to show that Stampin' Up! Really puts out a quality product. I'm impressed. And we are going to need our embossing buddy, our Versamark stamp pad, our gold embossing powder. These are Stampin' Up. I don't keep them in the containers because this is easier for me. And this is a concoction of about half clear and half gold glitter, both from Stampin' Up. So this is going to make a wonderful sparkly, glittery embossing powder. It's really nice. It can be fine detail, but you're not going to get super fine detail out of it. If any of you purchased the Real Red and Emerald Envy Stampin' Emboss Glitter from the holiday catalog last fall, Christmas, then it's similar to that. So, and you can truly customize it depending on how much glitter to clear you put in. So if you're wanting something that's more of a solid glitter, you would add more glitter. So we're gonna have fun with that. And then I've got snail adhesive, of course, and some of the foam adhesive strips, because I want some dimension and I want some solid dimension. The dimensionals, they're fantastic, but unless I put 100 of them on the card, I don't think it'll work. So, all right, so here is the Eastern Beauty stamp set. We are gonna be using a couple stamps from this. I have pulled out this one here, and the Let's Be Friends Forever. Yes, Let's Be Friends Forever. And just so you know, these are not actual size. They've shrunk them down so they'll fit on here. So This is a pretty substantial sentiment. And I've also pulled out the hello, it's me. Okay, all right. So for those of you wondering, this is pretty. These are the Eastern medallion framelits, thinlets. I can't remember which one they actually are. They're dies. So these are the different ways that I put them together. So we've got this one with that little bit and with that center. That. So again, if you want to learn more about all of that, hit up my Eastern medallion die video to kind of see more of what's what with that. And I also have the lemon lime twist. You can use any color that you like. I just picked this one. All right, so let's get started, shall we? All right, I've also decided to add in some fresh fig ink, so you'll need this too. And if you get the Eastern Palace bundle, you will have it. All right, let us start off first with, let's see, we'll do this card first. So we're gonna need the Blushing Bride Circle, the flowery type of medallion, and the fresh fig cardstock, card base. So let's go ahead and get this folded up. Got my handy dandy Stampin' Up! Bone folder. You wouldn't think it makes a difference. I never would have, but it really does. All right, so before we do anything, I want to just tuck these little bits back in so that as they're popped out, they don't get in the way of the stamping. And now we're going to take this little guy, it's like the three little teardrop shapes, and our lemon lime twist stamping pad. And we are just going to stamp in between each one of the petals, we will call it. Here we have just that little extra pop of lemon lime. All right, I've actually got everything, you know, piled up on my Stampin' Scrub, and that is not going to help me when it comes time to cleaning stamps or anything like that. Oh, all right, there we go. That one is all clean and ready to go back home. We're done with the lemon lime twist. Let's go ahead and pull out the fresh fig and our Let's Be Friends Forever stamp set. I'm going to ink that up with the fresh fig. All right. And this I'm going to just pop right over here in the corner. There we go. Nice even pressure. If you ever have issues with your photopolymer stamps giving a good image, they don't have the cushion that your wood stamps or your clear mount stamps have. There's no extra oomph, like they're really thin. So having something like a Stampin' Pierce mat underneath it really helps to give that extra cushion. I'm working on the entire pack of Stampin' Up! Grid paper, so that gives it a little cush. But yeah, if you're working on a hard surface, you might find that your photopolymer stamps do not stamp as nicely as you'd want. And notice that photopolymer do tend to stain. It's okay. It's not hurting the stamps any. Everything's fine. All right, so now we can go ahead and pop up the petals again. If you wanted to, you could ink up the edges of these petals to give them a little extra something. I don't feel that we need to do that. I think it's okay. So now I'm going to take that piece of Blushing Bride and we're going to adhere it onto the back. And I'm not going to do anything fancy with this because nobody's going to see it. I'm just going to use some regular old tape just to seal it on. Because there's not a huge edge around it, like I don't want any adhesive to be seen. I don't want it to come up through the image at all. So I'm just going to be fairly generous with this tape and just go around because I don't want it to pop up. All right, there we go. Oh, look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? It is so much prettier in real life. I really wish that glitters and shimmers really came through on camera, but they're always so much prettier in person. But look at that. Okay, and then to finish up this card, you could ink around the edges of this. You could go ahead and corner punch the edges. I think I'm going to do that. Now, I know that this is retiring, but a corner punch is a corner punch. This is a really nice corner punch. We'll have to wait and see if there's a nice replacement in the new annual catalog. If this is good. If it's still available, I recommend you get it. It would be pretty wonderful. All right, and I think, yep, we're going to take our, you know what? I had to get the snail adhesive, but I don't think we're going to use any of the snail adhesive. So, all right, here we go. We've got our foam strips here. Now, I like these a lot when I am wanting the entire background to be raised up. So I am treating it very similar to a shaker card. And just lining it all the way around so it's a nice even height going round and round. Alright, and this piece I'm going to do there, and then I've got a spare little piece that's in here that I can go ahead and grab. Decided to stick inside the package, but you're not doing me any good in there. So there we go. We're going to take off our paper backings. Just like so or not. There we go. Now all the paper backing is removed. And we're just going to place it right on top, trying to get it even. Make sure all the adhesive is down. There we go. Isn't that so pretty? You could add some pearls or rhinestones or even some of the vinyl stickers. We might actually do that. There's some new sequins that are coming out that look like they're going to be a lot of fun. You can always add on sequiny stuff. And just wanting to anchor in the sentiment just a little bit, just so it doesn't feel like it's like floating there. But all right, you could, you know, add a rhinestone to the center, again, the sequins, you know, something nice and, you know, organic. That would be so much fun. But all right, that is it for this card. Because it's a dark card base, I do suggest that you cut another sheet of like Whisper White or Very Vanilla and pop it on the inside. Since this is Whisper White, I would go with Whisper White. You can stamp that, get some decoration going on that. And then you have some place to write your sentiment. I usually cut these to be 4 by 5 1/4 to fit on here, but you can do whatever you want. It's the inside of the card, it's your card. Once I get my Stampin' Write markers in the new in colors, I will probably take some lemon lime, the lemon lime one, and just do little dashes all the way around, and that would complete it for me. All right, let's move on to the next card. Right, now on to the next card, and it's going to be this lovely card front. And we're going to need our piece of Very Vanilla, again, largest circle from the layering circles, or it doesn't have to be a circle. You could absolutely just cut a square. I just thought, hey, I've got it, so why not? All right, now this we are going to use our embossing on. So I'm going to get some embossing buddy on this. Not that I really need to. I'm covering InversaMark, but it's just habit, okay? It's just habit. Now, at this point, you can take and use either one of these, the gold or the gold glitter. I'm wanting to use the gold glitter because I want some sparkle and shine. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up and get it ready. Ready to go. Oh, doesn't that look so pretty? Okay, and now I'm just going to get VersaMark all over this circle. Now this is going to be the wonderful fun part. Finding a way to get this into that without my fingers getting icky. So, or just like getting in the way. So I'm just going to take these little fine tip tweezers. You're not going to see that part anyway because it's going to be behind. And now, time for the more magic. Lovely. So pretty. Especially once all of this gets melted down. I want to make sure it gets plenty on there. Tap off the excess. Oh, this is going to be nice. All right, close this up, because knowing me, I would make it go everywhere. So now I'm going to heat up my heat tool. So on the Stampin' Up! Heat tool, you have two options, one and two. One is fantastic for quick drying your watercolor, your inks, that sort of stuff. Two is what you're going to want to use to emboss with. Let it heat up for a little bit, and then you're going to bring it to your project. Okay, there we go. You know what? I forgot with this one, it's not just the clear embossing powder. I've also got some of the gold embossing powder in it. Now, on camera, this isn't looking completely solid. And in real life, it isn't either. The wonderful thing about embossing is you can add another layer of VersaMark over this, another layer of the embossing powder, and get a really solid look. And you know what? I think that is what I'm going to do. Just because it's here and it's available. And embossing is really inexpensive. It might be a little bit just to invest in everything, but your embossing powders are going to go so far, so far. So you're going to have these for a really long time before you're going to need to repurchase any of these. Oh, and in one of my posts, I did actually put how much it would be for like your basic set from Stampin' Up, like getting everything that you need to do the basics, and then if you wanted to get everything that Stampin' Up! Has for embossing, and see if I can find that and go ahead and pop it on there. Actually, I think I still have it written on a notepad hanging in my office. Because I really do, I love heat embossing, and I think it's something that really does bring your card making and crafts to the next level. All right, here we go. All right, there we go. Much more solid and fun and blingy. And I will say another tip, whenever you're working with like a glitter Stampin' Emboss sort of powder, heat from underneath. You're supposed to do that anyway. Heat your embossing from underneath. Not many people actually do, but I do suggest doing it with the glitter because when I was first going over it, it was flying everywhere because, you know, there is enough of a wind power to kind of blow it off. So, little tip. So there we go. I've basically made my own glimmer paper now, haven't I? So you can do this at home too. Of course, now I'm going to be covered in glitter because you know anytime you work with glitter, that's what happens. All right. So while we have this, I'm going to grab the regular gold Stampin' Emboss powder. And we're going to get some Embossin' Buddy down there. Get our VersaMark out and our Hello stamp, and we're just going to just be nice and gentle right over here in the corner. There we go. Nice little hello. I kind of started to feel like Bob Ross there. Happy little hello
in the corner with her happy little medallion. Just need some trees, some happy little rivers.
I'm not making fun of Bob Ross. Love him. I always wanted to paint like him. I actually did buy some of his little kits teaching you how to paint like him. There we go. Look at that. Just a nice little gold hello. All right. Now on to making the rest of the card. Oh, again, I'm just going to use some handy dandy basic tape. Now this medallion, it's a little bit bigger in size. So really want to make sure that I'm actually getting it where I am wanting it to be. Look at that. Just so much gorgeousness. So much, so much. Okay, let's go ahead and corner around this too. All right, and with this one too, you can absolutely ink up the edges. You can do some stitching around it. Like, I think if you happen to have like a Versamark pen of some kind, you can just draw a little bit around the edges and then do some gold embossing on that. I think that would be really pretty. We're not going to do that. We're keeping it simple. All right, let's get our Tranquil Tide paper. Now, this is something, if you order the bundle, you're not going to be able to get this until June 1st when the annual catalog goes live. So lots of early stuff that you get to get your hands on and play with before they're actually released. You know, the very vanilla note cards or the thick, very vanilla cardstock. These are other things that you can get your hands on early. You know, the three in colors, Lemon Lime Twist, Tranquil Tide, and Fresh Fig. These are all things that you get early if you get one of the bundles. And of course, there's, you know, the stamp set or the dies, whatever you happen to, whichever set you're purchasing, you get all of that early. All right, there we go. Let's just add one more little bit up here, and we'll get our adhesive backings off, and then our cards will be all done. So that didn't take too much, did it? Got some nice, pretty cards. Some simple and elegant cards. But I can also see these, like if you know, did some more punching. Now this is begging for a little something, and I think it's gonna need a rhinestone. Could do more of the stickers, but those are all gold, and I kind of feel like I want a little something more. So that's a big rhinestone, and now I want to take one of these smaller ones and pop it right up there, and then let's take another one of the big ones and just pop it right in the center of there. There we go. Just a nice, simple, elegant card. You know, I think that these, like, you really need to just let the gorgeousness of the dies, like, really just jump out and say, hey, sup, we're here, we're lovely, yay! But just so much gorgeousness. So let me bring you in a little bit so that you can really see these cards. Remember, there's going to be more pictures on the coordinating blog post. So I also want to show you, look at that. It's standing up. It's elevated off. I know it's hard to see when it's all like 2D and everything, but it really gives just a little extra something. So here we go. I'm going to try to hold them close and not have my fingers too much in the way. So there's our projects for today. Gorgeousness. Well, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please go ahead and like and subscribe. Feel free to comment. I love getting your feedback. And again, if there are any stamping up products that you want me to demonstrate, any techniques you want me to show you, expand on, you know, whatever, go ahead and leave me a comment and I'll do what I can. A full list of the products I used will be found in the description bar, along with links to the coordinating blog post. Again, the blog post usually has more pictures, so if you really want to see what these guys are looking like in good light, then that's the way to go. You can also find links to my online store down in the description bar and over on my website. You can head over to my website too and sign up for my newsletter. There's also the birthday club, so if you want a handmade birthday card from me on your birthday, go ahead and fill out your birthday and address. I do not sell your information or anything. This is between me and you. Nobody else gets it. So there's that. You can follow me on Facebook and Instagram. Facebook, I do Facebook Live every Friday around 6 or 7 p.m. Eastern Time. We do lots of fun little projects. I've got good things planned. And for the rest of this week, I'm going to be focusing on the Eastern Palace Suite. So look forward to at least two more projects, and then a Facebook Friday, probably, also with this. And then I will probably switch back to focusing on the retired products that we have to say goodbye to. But all right, so that's it. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye!